Hello everyone, so welcome back to this channel once again, and in this video session I'll discuss QSNDDTAQ in RPG programming. So basically we're going to write data to the data queue using QSNDDTAQ API in RPGLE program. So this API basically used to send or write data to the data queue which is existed on a system. So the required parameters for this API QSNDDTAQ API is, first one is data queue name, which is an input parameter and of length 10 characters. Second is library name, which is again input parameter and of 10 characters. Then length of data, which is input parameter and whose length is packed 5.0. And again the data, which is an input parameter, which we going to write. That's the varying character. So these are the four parameters which are the required parameters which I'm discussing here. There are other two other optional parameters as well which can be used, but we are not discussing them there here. So we talked about the data QSNDDTAQ API and its required parameter. Now let's move on to the coding so that we should see that how we write the RPGLE program and using QSNDDTAQ API to send the data to the data queue. So we'll see all these formats: fixed format, free format, that is slash free or end free, and the fully free format. So we'll see all codes in all the format. Let's see one by one. So first thing is, this code is in slash free and slash end free format, which is where C specs is in fully, it is in free format, and the other specs are in fixed form. Here you can see free slash end free format, where I'm using the QSNDDTAQ API. This is the way to define the prototype to this external program QSNDDTAQ, because I'm going to call this program. If you do work object on this program, you'll see that this program existed in QSIS library, which is basically dealt with the so I'm defining a prototype named QSNDDTAQ and calling this external program QSNDDTAQ. Here the required parameters are these four: data queue name, which is constant, data queue lib, which is constant, data length constant, and data buffer constant. So 10 10 5 packed decimal 0, data buffer 32767A. This is options star var size, though, so we can send the varying size data here. Now this is the main prototype or main procedure interface. Since this is replacing the star entry param, basically earlier we were using the star entry, now we are using this in place of a star entry, so that whatever the input parameters we are accepting to this program, extpgm5, that is this one, data queue name, data queue library name, and data which you want to write. So these three parameters basically will be passed from the command line or by while calling the program. This program extpgm5, which is using QSNDDTAQ API to send the data to the data queue, being passed. Now this is here, this is I'm calling QSNDDTAQ API. So this will call this procedure, basically this program, passing the data queue name which is passed, data queue library which is passed, and the data which is passed, and the length of that data. So we will be trimming first and then calculating the length using the percentile length function, and we'll be calling the API like this. This will write the data into the data queue being passed in the data queue name. and then we'll set the last record indicator to on and return from the program. So this is the /free/end free format. Let's discuss for the fully free. So here you can see the first line, first column, *free, which is compulsory here, mandatory here, and the rest of the line is must be blank. That's for the fully free. Now we are declaring the procedure prototype for this QSNDDTAQ, and we are calling that external program as the XCPG. Now we are not specifying the names of the parameters because that's not required. This is just a definition. So we are specifying what the prototype is: cat 10 const, packed 5:0 const, char 32767 const, options, star var size. So this is basically replacing the fixed format into the fully free format declaration for the prototype. Then we are accepting the input parameters to this program, excpgm5 #1. So we declare DCLPI NPI here. Star N means for the main procedure, data queue name, data queue library, and the data which we are going to write to the data queue. So this would come as an input parameter, and this is the prototype which we are going to call next. QSNDDTAQ, where we pass the data queue name being received as an input parameter, data queue library, data, and the length of that data by trimming that data and calculating the length using the percent length function. Last records indicator set to on and return from program. So this is the fully free format RPGLE code for writing the data to the data queue using QSNDDTAQ API. Next thing is fixed format. So nothing free used here. Even the C specs is in fixed format. So all the specs are in fixed format. So here you can see I'm declaring the, I'm replacing the star and key parameter with the PRPI. You can even use star entry here, and you can declare the parameters which you are taking as an input parameter to this program. Now you can see this is the procedure interface, means the input parameters to this program, data queue name, data queue library, and the data which we want to send to the data queue. This is a standalone variable which we declared as a length so that we could calculate the length by trimming that data which we are taking as an input to this program. We are not defining the prototype for this call QSNDDTAQ, which we are doing for the RPG fully free format and the /free or /end free format. So there we are declaring the prototype because we are going to call it as a prototyped call using callp, which is again optional to use. But here you can see I'm not using callp method, I'm directly calling the program QSNDDTAQ by using call in the fixed format RPG. So here I am passing the parameter as the data queue name, data queue library, and the length which is being calculated, and the data which is to be sent to the data queue. Last record indicator is set to on using the set on opcode or function, and then return from the program. So that's what the fixed format code is for writing data to the data queue using QSNDDTAQ API. So these are the three format code, /free/end free, fully free, and the fixed format. Now let's compile all of them. This is compiled, this is again compiled, and this again compiled. Now we discussed about using QSNDDTAQ API in RPG program in fixed, free, and fully free format. Let's move on to the next point, creating a data queue named this in library easy class 1 using createDTAQ command. So let's create a data queue so that we can write data to that data queue, just for demonstration. and testing of these three programs. So this is going to be a standard data queue. Let's create a data queue of length 5000, means every entry placed with the up to the length of 5000 can be placed. Just to the work object, you can see data queue 1 is created in easy class 1. Now we need to write the data. First of all, just check whether there is any data or not. We can call this table function qsys2.dataqueue data underscore queue underscore entries to check whether there is any entry in this data queue or not. So we can see there is no entry at all. Now let's call these programs. Call extpgm5 and then pass the data queue name as this one, data queue 1 plus data queue library this one. Let's hello pass hello and then call this one. So you can see the program is complete. Let's check has been written to this. So first entry is hello. Now let's call 5 hash 1 which is the fully free one, and I'm going to write VS400 and SQL tricks. Has been called. Let's check AS400 and SQL tricks has been written as the second entry. Now let's call PGM hash 2, which is the fixed format, totally free form, fixed format. Let's dot com, let's pass dot com only. So you can see this program is called again just QSJSQL. You can see all the three entries have been placed on the data queue. Data queue 1. Just check whether there is anything in job log. Nothing as such reported here. So, you have seen that we just called the programs written in fixed, free or fully free format one by one, and write the data to the data queue using those programs. Now we have displayed the data using the SQL UDTF. So we'll be running the SQL UDTF to get entries of a specified data queue using the QSys2. Data underscore queue underscore entries user defined table function. So that's a table function which we are basically using. Select cast message data as character data as character 50. So we have casted this message data up to length 50 from table because we are using table. Just because this is a table function, this is two dot data underscore queue underscore entries, and inside this table function we are passing the parameters. There could be many more parameters which we can specify here. So first one is data queue, and data queue name is data queue 1, and the other one is data queue library. So we pass this one. So you can see the results are on the display screen where you can see that the data has been written with the entries mentioned, that is 1, 2 or 3. So that's all in this video. So you got the demo that how you will going to use QSNDDTAQ API to write the data to the data queue, and how you will be going to write the code in fixed format RPG / free or / end free RPG, or fully free RPG. So that's all in this video. Thank you and have a nice time.